everyone and welcome back to my channel. For this week's Make What You See in the Shops, we're gonna make a plaid skirt, and you must have seen all the plaid skirts in the shops now and online. And I found this beautiful cashmere fabric that has plaids in gray and pink, a bit of darker pink, and it's really nice fabric, of course, because it's cashmere. You know that I like cashmere, and it's a really nice wool. And the nice thing of wool is that it falls very nicely. So we're gonna make a skirt out of it. So I'll show you what my inspiration was and what we're gonna make out of it. And if you like these kind of videos, please subscribe or consider subscribing when you have seen this tutorial. And please share with others and like my videos if you like them.
And here are some examples of plaid skirts that you can find online. You see them all kinds. Most are pencil skirts or more A-line, like in the mid below. That white one is more an A-line. The two on the right are more half circle skirts. I think that's more for little girls, not for adults, so I don't like that very much. I like them more tailored with dots in the front and in the back, or just only in the back. Also, what is important, and that's why I also put in that white corner one, the below in the corner, is that when you have a plaid fabric, you must be sure that the lines are connecting at the seams. Otherwise, it will look very cheap. So make sure you cut your patterns nicely, one by one, so that you can align the lines that they go on from left to the right side, or from top to bottom, or whatever is your seam is going. Make sure that your stripes are aligned. So I'm gonna make a tailored one with pleats in the back. For me, I'm gonna make it an A-line skirt, but you can also make it a pencil skirt. I will show you both how to do that. We'll make a zipper in the back with a button, so we also make a waistband. And I'm gonna line it, because I don't like a woolen skirt without lining. But that's very easy to do, because we just sew the lining onto the hem, and then you flip it up to the top, and then you just put a waistband on. So it's not difficult to line it, and we're gonna do it like that. I'm gonna show you how we make the pattern, and we're gonna use that for that our basic pattern, and I'll show you how we're gonna make the adjustments.
And again, I made my fabulous drawing. It's pretty simple. It's just a plain skirt. You can make it a pencil skirt, and you go just with the side seam straight down that we have in our basic pattern. But I like it more when it's just a little bit flared out, a little bit of an A-line, because I think that looks more nice on me. And I like it a little bit longer. So most of the skirts that we saw in the inspiration are way above the knees. You can make it certainly, no problem at all. And also you can make it as a pencil skirt or as an A-line skirt, but I will make mine at about knee length, because I like it more. I even like more mid-calf length, but with this fabric I don't think that is so nice. So I will make it knee length and then a little bit flared out. I won't make the darts in the front, because I don't really like how that looks on me, because it is better when you have a rather curvy figure, and I have quite some difference between my waist and my hips. But with this fabric, with the plaids, I don't like it when you see here stitching. So I won't do it, but if you like it, or if you know that it looks better on your body type, then certainly do it, because normally a skirt looks nicer when you make darts in the front. I will make darts in the back, the two that we have in our basic pattern. The rest of the pattern is just the same, it's just the width that makes the difference because of the darts. And then we put on just a waistband, a zipper in the mid-back with a button on the mid of the waistband. And that's it. If you make your skirt shorter, you can also make a slit in the front, as one of the inspo pictures had. I think that looks really nice, but because mine is rather long, I don't think that will be flattering, so I'll just make it plain on. And what we do, we're gonna line it, so that will be just the same pattern as this. The front and the back will be the same, and while sewing I show you how we do that. Then for the pattern, you will need your basic pattern as always. So if you don't have your basic pattern yet, I will link down below in the description box my tutorial how to make the basic pattern for the skirt. I also have a basic pattern for a top and for trousers. So if you like that, just search in my videos where the basic patterns are, and I will link them in the description box below too. So take your basic pattern, take a new piece of fabric so that you can retrace your pattern. And as I said, what I want is, I don't want my dart here, so I don't need this width extra to the side that we draw on. So I will take the curve that is without the dart, because you don't need that extra space that you're gonna miss when you close that up. What I want to do is, I want to flare out the side seam. So I'm gonna mark where my mid front is. I'm gonna trace that first. And then I'm gonna flare out my side seam. So I'm gonna trace, I'll just trace the outside line, and I'll take it back to the inside later on. I just go to where they match, and then I'll just flare it out a bit. It doesn't have to be too much, but just a little bit. I like a little bit more than just a pencil skirt now. So I just flare it out a little bit, and then I mark where the official line was. Yeah, and this is not needed. So that is for my front, very easy. The same for the back. The only thing I have to change is again the side seam. And what you can do is what I will do now, but I will do that off camera. I will cut this one out, and then I put this side seam on this one. Then I get the exact same curve as the front one, and then you have the side seams nicely matching. So that is for the pattern. If you want to make the pencil skirt, of course, just take this basic pattern. Then you don't have to alter anything. The basic pattern is just for a plain pencil skirt, so you can use that straight on. And for, we're gonna cut that out of the fabric. And for the outer fabric, it will be this pattern. For the lining, it will be the same. And as you see, I didn't put pockets in the skirt because I think I don't like it with this fabric to make pockets, but you certainly can do yourself. I have lots of tutorials how to make pockets here in the side seams, or how to make pockets with some inserts. You can also just sew a pocket on. One of the inspo pictures had a pocket with just a small flap here. You can do that too, but I think I like it more rather plain, that you can see the nice pleats, plaits, and I will not make pockets in this skirt. And as I told you, when you sew with plaits, make sure that the lines are going on in the seams, and especially in the mid-back. So what I do is, I put my mid-front on the fold, and make sure your fold is straight, because mine was not. So make your fold straight, and then put your mid front there, cut that out, then place your back part aligned with the side seam that it is connected to, and then you cut that out just one piece, and then the other part you will align with the other side of your fold pattern, and then also match your mid parts together with the back. So for the other mid, for the other back part, you have to align it with your other mid back and with the other side seam. So be careful, place them next to each other, and then make sure that the lines are going on. So we have now our skirt cut out out of the fabric and the lining, and you see I cut my lining 3 centimeters shorter than the skirt, and you will see when we're gonna line it why I did that, because then you don't have to hem anything. You can just sew the lining onto the fabric, and then when you fold it in, you have a nicely finished hem. You'll see that later on. So we both have now all the pieces. What we're gonna do first is, we're gonna sew the side seams and the mid back, and of course the darts. And you can do the side seams first or the darts first. I always like to start with the darts, so make sure you have pinned them out rightly. Put the pins on the top together, and then fold them to where your end pin is, and then sew that. And if you've never done that, I have a tutorial on how to make darts And it is how to make dots the professional way, because you can just sew it down. But it's a nice way to do it, and it looks really nice here at the end, because sometimes you get a bump or a dump and it looks not that nice. So if you're not familiar with sewing dots, then watch that tutorial. So we're gonna sew that, the dots first. Then take your back part, put your front parts on top of it, right sides together of course. And you can sew both the side seams all the way down, and you can finish the mid back or sew the mid back already until the zipper, depending on what kind of zipper you will use. If you use a regular zipper, you can sew the mid back close. If you sew with a blind zipper, you just finish the seams first and then put in your zipper. And when you go start doing the side seams, make sure you pin your lines exactly on top of each other, the front and the back. I do that with horizontal pins, and I'm sure that they cannot shift from each other, because these lines really have to go through to the other side. That looks really more nice and not that cheap. And while pinning in my zipper, I noticed that my lines weren't matching. You see that here? Here's the pink one, and then it skips to here. So somewhere I missed something and I didn't pin it right. And to me this is very annoying. So I'm gonna seam rip this whole mid seam, and we're gonna pin it again, and I'm gonna sew it again, because this is what I was talking about. To me it's very annoying when the lines aren't matching and just going on, but take a skip. And I think when you can fix it, just seam rip it, do it again, because you really have more satisfaction of your work when it's really nice and crisp. So I'm gonna seam rip and then again put my zipper in. So if you sew the outer fabric sew exactly the same your lining, then you have two exactly the same skirts. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna pin in the zipper. So turn your skirt right side out, and I decided to use a normal zipper for this one. You can also do an invisible zipper, and I have a separate tutorial about that. I don't have one about a normal zipper because it is very easy to do. So I've sewn my mid back seam until the zipper, where the zipper ends or starts. And what you do is make sure you have finished this part too, the other ends of the seam allowance, and then you fold in your fabric and just align that with the middle of your zipper. So make sure you have your both sides matching. And if you think that's difficult to do by pinning just when it's open, you can make a basting stitch here on the top part of your seam, leave the stitching in, then pin the zipper on, sew it on, and then take your basting stitch out. But because this is a very thick, sturdy fabric, for me it is very easy to just pin it in and then sew it in without the basting stitch. But you can do that if you find this is difficult. And make sure again that your lines are really nicely matching. So now you have your zipper in. And what we're going to do now is we're going to put the upper part into the lining so that the white sides are together. And then we're going to pin the hem together, the hem lines. Like this. And you just start at the side seams, pin them together. And then just pin all the way around and then sew that. And then I'll come back and show you what happens when you do that. It's a very easy way of lining and at the same time hemming your skirts. Bit that it's better to see. So when you have sewn that bottom, that hemline, and you flip your lining into the skirt, so like it is supposed to be with the wrong sides together, and then you flip it out, so you can also put the outer fabric inside, because what I want to show you is what you have, because we made our lining 3 centimeters shorter than the outer fabric, and when you sew them together and you match the top part here together by pinning it down, you can see when you iron it that you have nicely hemmed this part, because these are together here are sewn together, and then when you sew when you iron it, you have a really nice finished hem with your lining on connected. So there's nothing else to do there. It's nicely finished, like it should be, like a really professional thing looks like. And it's a very easy way, because now you have your lining already attached, and the only thing you have to do is make your waistline here on top of it. And I told it very many times in my videos, but I think I didn't say it this time. Iron every seam after you made it, immediately after you made it. So always have your iron on hand. When you make your side seams, when you make your darts, iron it down immediately, because then you get a better look how the fabric is, how it looks, how it fits. Also now, immediately iron that hemline down, pin the top parts together, and then fold them together, and then it easily falls like this, and then you flatten it down, press it down. That looks really nice, and then you have nothing else to do there. That's totally finished now. So you have here now your zipper on the outer fabric. This is still loose, so I always do this by hand. I sew this down by hand, the lining onto the zipper band. You can do it with the machine, but it's very difficult to do that nicely, so I always do that by hand. I'll do that first, and then I'll take my waistband. I didn't know if I told you how to cut this, but you can measure the top of your skirt. I always measure my own waistline, how much that is, and I cut that out, plus an extra about 5 centimeters for the overlap. And I cut this down 6 centimeters. So I'm gonna reinforce half of the band so that it gets some strength. I iron that on, then you fold it together. You close up the two ends by just make a stitch here at the end, the both ends of your waistband. Then fold it open to the right side, iron it again, that it is really nice and crisp and flat. And then you pin it on the top of your skirt with one side, so that all the way around. Then flip it over to the other side, and then you can choose if you want to sew that down in the stitch that you just made. They call it stitch in the ditch. It's very nice way to finish it. You can also just fold it in on the inside, fold it in, and then sew it by hand on. That's good too. And then you make a button on the end, buttonhole, and the whole skirt is finished. So good luck with the last pieces, and then I will come back with the end result. And the waistband with the reinforcement ironed on, and then you flip it over, and then you have nicely reinforced waistband. Show you how I do my stitch in a ditch. That means that you make your stitching here in the seam where you attach the waistband, is I flip my seam allowance under and I pin that down with that those diagonal pins, and then I flip it to the right side and I pin it in the ditch, and then I can see on the wrong side if the pins are on my seam allowance on my waistband. Then I'm sure that when I'm stitching in the ditch that I'm attaching it, because sometimes you get your pin here and then you haven't attached your seam allowance of your waistband. So now you can take the diagonal pins out. I usually keep them in so that I'm sure that it will stay in place like this. But be sure that you take your pin heads a little bit down, that you don't stitch over them, because then your needle will break. But when you take them out a little bit, then you can just stitch them over from the right side, and then you have a really nice stitch here in the edge in the ditch that you don't see, and it looks very nice and very polished when you do it like that. So I'm gonna stitch it down, and then I'm gonna make my button and buttonhole. Here is the skirt, and I like it very much. I managed to get all my lines going through. I even by accident could make lines going on into my waistband, and that was just by accident. I was pinning it on and I thought, okay, I can get that also. So it's very nice, and really when you when I say it, you may think, oh, it's not such of a difference, but when you compare like skirts from Shein or Runway or something like that, also H&M, then you will see that the lines in the skirts won't be connecting, and especially in the mid-back and also in the side seams, you will see a difference when you compare it with a more difficult, a more expensive skirt, and that makes really a difference in how things look. And when you know it, you will notice it, and you will see what annoying it is when it's not right, and when you don't know it, it's no problem, but you definitely will see it now. And I think it looks really way better when you see all the stripes going all around, and especially going into the waistband. That was really nice. And you see why I wanted my the two darts in the back. I have a very flat butt, so normally it will go straight down, and now with the darts it will be a little bit more rounded. So I like that very much more. I don't want it in my front. To me it doesn't look nice, because then I get more of a belly that you normally don't have or hardly have. So that's why I don't make it in the front, but you can certainly do. And I have a very small waist compared to my hips, so I should make darts, because then it's better to do darts, but I don't think it looks nice on me. And that's the nice thing when you make it yourself. You can make it just how you want it, to your body type, what you think looks nice. And well, this was a really nice one. I like my flared out vision. You can also make it just like a pencil skirt, but I don't like to be constricted like this, but you can certainly do that. There are lots of skirts like a pencil skirt now in the shop, so you can certainly do it like that, but I like it more, a little bit loose, a little bit more wide. And well, I'm very happy with the result. What I found out because of a comment that I got on a former video, way back, but I just got the comment now, that I don't, well, I explain a lot, but some things I don't tell anyone, because I think, well, you already know that, and I don't explain it anymore, but I think I should, because not everyone watches every video that I make, and not everyone watches since the beginning. And the person said, well, maybe you should mention that you should wash and iron your fabrics before you cut them. And I told that many, many times in my older videos, but I stopped telling that because I thought, well, you know now, and it's very annoying when you hear things over and over again. I think it's annoying. But when you first hear, or maybe just you saw just a few videos from me that you maybe haven't heard it say, tell me. So I think I will, in the coming videos now, will more also tell the basics, the things like do a backstitch. It's very common, and because I've told it so many times, I think you know it, but when you're new, you maybe don't know it. So I'll try to again say all those things also in every video for the new ones or for the people that don't watch every week. So you really have all the basics and all the specifics that you need to know when you want to be sewing, when you want to be really good sewing. And let me know if you think it's annoying. If you watch every week my videos and you think, okay, I know it by now, then I will stop telling it and I will put it in my description box. But I think not many people read description boxes, and there are even people that don't even know that you can drop down the description box. There's way more information down there. I was very surprised to hear that, because for me it was just normal that you drop down the description box with what you want to know. So when you think it's annoying that I say too much in between, that is really obvious by now, let me know, and then I will just don't say it anymore in the videos. I will just put it in the description box. But I thought it was very important that that person mentioned it, because I wasn't aware of it, and because I already tell so much in my videos, because I want this to be not tutorials but really sewing classes. So that it really also for beginners that never have sewn before, they can really make this skirt, because you know exactly what to do, how to do, why to do, what fabric to do, what to do with the fabric. And I really want to make these videos like that. That is really classes, not tutorials, really things you can learn from the beginning to the end. And when you've never done it before, you've never heard it before, you can do it also. But I also want it to be nice for experienced people, and that's why I also give some tips and tricks in between, that maybe when you're beginning you think, oh, that's too much for me, then just leave it out. It's just for the people that want to do a little bit more, a little bit step up to the things they're already doing, to make it more fun, or to make it more nice, or more sophisticated, professional, to give them a more professional look, or to do it more professional. Because I like it very much when my inner side of the garments are also very nicely finished, and our people are saying, oh, no one sees it, okay by me, I don't do that. But like these hemlines, I really like this, how this looked, how this is finishing. You see that it's very easy to line a skirt like this. It's not even more work, it's less work, because you don't have to hem two parts, the outer and the lining, because you just sew them together and you have it hemmed and lined. And I like this finish very much. So that's all the little things that I like to give you, to teach you. And that's why I make my videos so long, because I really want it to be classes and not just tutorials like many other sewing channels are. They just show you what they make and then that's it, and you don't have a pattern, you don't know how they made the pattern, you don't know exactly how they are sewing it together, just they do it for their result, and that's very nice. But I like to teach you how to do it, because otherwise I don't have to make videos. It costs me a lot of energy, and then I can better sit at my sewing machine and sew for myself. And it's way easier to do, way quicker to do, but I like to teach you how to do this, because I think it's such a nice craft, and I want to share it with you so that you can make it yourself too. Because I, looking now at my closet room, it is really full of all my clothing, because also this skirt you can wear over 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. I really have clothing in there that are more than 30 years old, because when you make classy things that are nice, that are nicely made, you can wear them forever, really forever. I have really things from over 30 years ago that I made, and I still wear them because they are still nice to wear now. And that's the nice thing, you make nice classy pieces, nicely made, you don't have to throw them away after 1, 2, 3 years. So I hope you like this tutorial. Please subscribe if you like my videos. Please leave me a comment if you have something to ask or something to say. I really like that. I really like to hear what you want me to do, or if you have something you like me to make, let me know, then I can make a tutorial out of that, a class, sewing class. So let me know, and please share, please like my videos, and I'll be back next Monday with a new sewing tutorial, sewing class. I have to learn it myself. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again next Monday. Bye.